up, you guys? Welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for watching.
What is up, you guys? Welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for watching. And welcome to another Hot Girl video, guys. Guys, before we get into the video, guys, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Hit that notification button down below so every single time your Caribbean girl posts a video, you're gonna be notified. Okay? So, without any further ado, let's get into the video. So I did post it on my Instagram story probably about a week or two weeks ago about the process about ordering, okay? I did state that you guys should get up to the times and y'all should start to order stuff online internationally, okay? And a few of y'all messaged me and told me, well, girl, do a video, whatever the case is. Two or three of y'all, okay? So this video is for the people who do not know how to order, okay? They don't know nothing about online shopping. They don't know how to purchase stuff. They don't know how to place an order. This video is for them. And I am delighted to do this video, guys, because I was once there, okay? I used to have people order stuff for me, and then they would come and hit you a whole lot of story, girl, and charge you way more than... You know, just learn to do your thing yourself. So this is where Whitney DB comes in to help you guys. All right, so guys, stick around, watch the entire video because it is very, very informative. Again, this video is for persons who are interested in shopping online, purchasing items, who lives in Trinidad and by extension the Caribbean. Okay, now this video is not for persons who are living international, because basically the principle of placing an order is the same. It's just that the techniques are different when you are living in a third world country. Okay, so this is how to order internationally when living in Trinidad and Tobago or anywhere in the Caribbean. All right, so guys, let's get into the video. Let's waste no more time. So number one, I have here, what is online shopping? So online shopping is shopping online, as it says, okay? So anything that you buy via a website, via Instagram, social media, any social media platform, guys, that is literally buying online. What is placing an order? So when you do place an order, it means to say that you made a purchase, okay? So when you go online and you see something that you like, shopping online is a general term, but when you buy something or you purchase something, you placed an order, meaning that you already purchased it, you paid for it, and you would receive an order number and it will be shipped directly to your house. Also, okay, number two, how do you place an order, or how do you even get online or whatever? In order to do online shopping, guys, you need to visit a website. Okay? Now, you can purchase stuff, as I mentioned earlier, via Instagram and social media. And you can meet up with the persons, etc. And exchange your goods or services for the cash. Okay? But this video, we are talking about basically websites. Alright? If you do not know what a website is basically an online platform where you can purchase goods and services. You will see www.whatever. Most times it is www. But nowadays there are different links that you can use to get to a company's page. Where do you find these websites? Nowadays, guys, you find these websites in people's companies, businesses, bio. Alright, so on Instagram or Facebook, you are going to look in to the top of their business page and you are going to see shop www.whatever, or click this link takes you directly straight to the website. Okay, some websites I'm just going to briefly mention are like Amazon and Fashion Nova, Shein, all those AliExpress, all those are websites, guys, that you go onto and you see thousands and hundreds of goods that you can buy. You cannot shop online if you do not have a website. So you need to going to these people things. Sometimes you would be on social media and you would see swipe up. You swipe up and it takes you directly to a website. Okay. Number three. Okay, so you know what is online shopping. You do know what is ordering. You found your website. You find your stuff that you want. Now, how do I get it? How do I purchase the bowl set that I'm seeing? So, in order to make a purchase online, guys, you need to have a credit card or a debit card. I'm going to briefly explain the both for y'all. A credit card is a Master Visa card that is loaded with money from your bank. So the card, it's an international card, it's a US card that comes with money on it. So if you order your card will come with 100 US, 200 US, well, how much ever US, and you can use it locally and you can use it internationally. Okay, a debit card is a card, is a reloadable electronic Visa card that you can purchase goods or services internationally and locally, but you have to put money onto the card. So let's just say you saw a bowl for $20 and you want it, you cannot just go to use your credit card to purchase the bowl. You have to go into the bank or via your online bank or whatever, convert the money to TT, sorry, convert the money to US, that is, and let's just say it's $7.20 for the bowl, $7.14, that's $140, for example, guys. You go into the bank, you pay $140 onto the card, and you are able to purchase the bowl in US or TT, right? So that's the difference there between a credit card and a debit card. So I'm just going to show you guys what a reloadable electronic Visa debit card looks like. This is the card that you can use to put money on. This is exactly how it looks. Now, this is a very old card, so don't try to grab the number and see if you can purchase something because it is expired. Okay, so basically the credit card and the debit cards look the same. It's just that it's just different color and the bank names is different on top, and basically that's it. Okay, so you would have your digits in front there, which is this long couple numbers that you are seeing there. You would see your expiry date to the bottom here. Mine's expired since 2020. Your signature in the back here, and then you have your serial number. Okay, everything is pretty self-explanatory on those sites. Also, there's features that where you can scan the card, all these great things that you can do. Okay, so I just want to show you all what a card looks like. There is a young lady on YouTube here. She is a Trinidadian. She has great videos explaining the differences between all the different debit cards and Visa cards and credit cards and so on. Okay, I'm going to put her name onto the screen here, guys. And y'all can probably check her channel out and look at some of her videos. I've been watching her videos and they are really super helpful. So she was featured in the Woman's Express talking about the different banks and cards and the features of them. So you can check her channel out and she explains more into that, all right? In order to get a credit card though, you just have to have like a job letter or some sort of document showing that you are able to pay back every time you use your card. Visa debit card, you really don't need all those documents. However, guys, due to the shortage of US into the world, so to say, there has been a hold on these cards, but there are people who still issue Visa debit cards, guys. So you need to do your research. You need to do your research and figure out, listen, how can I get a debit card to shop internationally? Now, there are a lot of debit cards now that the banks are coming out with, but and we can use it online, but only locally. We cannot use it internationally, and we are looking for that. We are looking right now for this video to purchase stuff that we see online and we want. Okay, so that is what you need. Your credit union, financial institutions, listen, so many different things. You need to do your research, okay? And you would get through, you would succeed. So you know what is online shopping. You know that you need to get onto our website to make a purchase. And now you know how you're going to get your stuff. You know exactly how you are going to pay for your stuff. All right? So, boom. So you're ready to pay for your stuff. But how am I getting it? How am I going to receive my goods that I'm living in Trinidad? Okay, guys. So, listen carefully. Jot down these points if you need to. So guys, to receive your goods, you need to have a skybox. A skybox is a service, guys, that is provided by a courier company, all right? So, for example, a skybox is just basically a web address that they give you. So these courier companies, they have a lot of warehouses in Miami, all right? So a lot of these goods around the world, they ship to Miami, okay? So it's like a main place where goods go to. So if your stuff is coming from China, Australia, wherever it is, it goes directly to Miami. So you are going to sign up with a courier company, right, to get a skybox. So when you get your skybox, guys, it's just basically they're going to give you the address of the warehouse and you are going to get your private web number. And this web number goes onto all your packages. So when inserting your shipping address, guys, you are going to put in your web number and everything that the company gives you when you sign up with them, your phone number, etc. And it works as gold. Also must mention, guys, that there are two ways that your stuff can come to you. Your stuff can come to you directly to Trinidad, which is you using your postal address, the same address that your mail comes to, your bank statements, your flow bill, your electricity bill, or you can use your skybox, okay? If you use your normal address at home, your stuff takes 21 to 30 days to get at your home. Okay, now also there are some websites, guys, you would see ships to Trinidad and Tobago, and then you would see some that says do not ship to Trinidad and Tobago. What it means is that that company, they don't go out of the way to ship anything to us. However, once you have your skybox and you use your Miami address, anyone ships to Miami, Canada, US and Canada. We know that for sure. Okay, so sometimes you go onto Amazon and you would see this product does not ship to Trinidad and Tobago, and that will pop up because automatically you Google and their whatever will pick up that your URL link is in Trinidad. So immediately it's gonna show you exactly where you are living and if it ships to here or not. But you don't need to worry about that. You just need to enter your Miami skybox and it goes directly to your Miami address. So it comes like if you are living in Miami and that warehouse is your house, you know, like that. Okay, so these people do not know it's a warehouse, guys. They just know that's the address that you gave and the person probably living there. All right, some of them, they do know it's warehouses, but you all understand what I'm trying to say. Okay, it is nothing hard, guys. I hope you all are following me. If you do not, just watch over the video and just jot down the point. So let's talk about the different courier services, company businesses that have in Trinidad. There are a lot, guys. There are a lot. There are WebSource, we have CSF, we have Tropical Express, we have so many. So you have to do your research, guys, and decide which one you want to go with. A lot of them, though, they vary with price. Some of them have annual fees. Some of them, they just take too long to bring your stuff. Currently I am with WebSource because for me, guys, WebSource is very effective. Their customer service is on point. They take a little long to answer the phone, though, but when you do get onto them, they are very, they know exactly what they are saying. And also, guys, what I like about WebSource is that they bring your goods directly to your house, okay? So it is free of charge. You do not need any money to sign up. You go onto the website and you literally sign up, and they send you your Skybox information immediately in your email, and you go from there. So back then, I'm not sure for now, I know back then certain Skybox places you had to go in and sign up, all those long paperwork, blah blah blah. Nobody got time for that, girl. Like, you need to sit home, create an email address, and just sign up your stuff, and you are good to go. There's no annual fee with WebSource. I must tell you guys though that WebSource is a bit expensive compared to others, but because of the quality and the performance, and they bring your stuff timely, they bring your stuff directly in front of your house, like the convenience, it is definitely worth it. Like WebSource, if you get your email saying, okay, your stuff has been shipped or whatever today, by the next couple hours you are receiving an email from WebSource, we have received your goods in our Miami warehouse. And girl, by the next couple days again, beep, 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 outside. However, right now, due to the COVID, guys, I must say that it is not like that right now. And I totally understand, because the entire world is going through the same thing. Things are taking forever to clear at the customs department in many airports globally, you know. So you need to do that, girl. And once you get that done, but if you do not have a credit card or a debit card, guys, and you know someone who has it, well then you can probably use that in the meantime, but you need to work on getting one for yourself. Okay, try your best. So you're going to receive your goods, they send you an email, and then you use your cash or card or whatever, you pay them whichever policy that they have at that point in time, and you are good to go. When you do order directly to your house, it takes at least 30 days, and if you are not in a hurry or a rush for anything, you can just pay that one fee and get it to you directly to your house, versus if you send it to Miami, you have to pay Miami fee, then you have to pay WebSource fee, you know. Currently, presently, I do have some items coming directly to my house, so I am just observing and waiting to see if it is going to take the 21 to 30 days or longer than that, because this company, they do ship directly to Trinidad, okay? So they would use like DHL or USPS or whatever whatever postal services you pay for or they decide to use, okay? So you know what is online shopping now. You have your credit card or your debit card, you go onto your website, girl, and then you made a purchase and it's shipping directly to you or to your Miami warehouse and then to you. Regardless of whichever one you choose, it is directly coming to your house, okay? Guys, and we need to take advantage of this. You can't just be backward and don't want to order stuff and don't know how to order stuff. Like, no, look at what is going on right now. We had to order almost everything online because why? Stores were closed, you know. Stores were closed. Don't be backward. Do these things for yourself. You have to learn along the way, you know. I was once there. I didn't know how to do anything at all, but I learned along the way, and now I know, okay? And I have many more to learn, but in terms of like clearing through the ports and so on, but I will learn that in time to come. And once I learn, you know, I'm coming to tell all of you. All right, guys, so I really hope you enjoy this video, guys. I am going to make a part two in this, showing you exactly how to plug in your information onto our website and how to use coupon codes. You know, nowadays we would see use code so by so to get 15% off, use code so and so to get 10% off, and I was one never used to use codes, but hello, listen, I am a code girl. I am using code all through the way because it really does give you discount, girl. All right, guys, so I hope you enjoyed this video, guys. Stick around for part two, and part two I'm just going to be showing you all, as I said, how to put in your coupon codes and how to put in your credit card and your shipping address and all of that, and y'all on all-night boiled corn, as they would say, okay? So thank you so much for watching, guys. Give this video a like. Help someone, share it, subscribe, guys, comment down below. Let me know if it worked, if you got through or whatever. And I'll definitely see you guys in my other video. Do take care of yourself. Bye, people! Alright, now let me just say, do not laugh at people who do not know, because there are many people that I know cannot order, who do not know how to order. And it's nothing hard, guys. It's just that they don't know. It's simple. They just don't know, okay?